It's a whole lot of money in the smoke.
Hey, Christine.
Hey, how are you?
Good, good. Yeah, so I think I told Mindick to come on. It's easier because, like, obviously I'm walking around and I can't multitask very well. So I had all the DMs last time. So they're happy to DM me, and then I'll probably get back to them, or I will get back to them via DM. But hoping that, you know, Matt, you know, DM.
Or Rue's here too.
Or Rue. Like, DM them so they can kind of, like, have it ready for me to kind of be talking and then to do it. I wasn't able to do that, but yeah.
Rue, are you able to take DMs?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, perfect. Okay, cool. Yeah, so go ahead, Matt, and then if you guys have any questions, just send over DMs and stuff, and then we'll try to have them over to Matt so he can answer.
Yeah, share the link, guys. I think Mindick's here. We'll just kind of run off. I'm just going to share it now again. We'll run off last week. Another exciting start to the week, guys. I'll probably only talk for, like, you know, 15, 20 minutes. And then, I'll have a coach for next week just to kind of go over, you know, the market and everything, guys, because we see that it's volatile, guys. It's the OTC. And as we can see, things can happen in the OTC to sway stocks and, you know, congratulations on everyone in today. What a run. I've had that before, and I didn't have it this time. So, you'll see that in the OTC. And you have to remember, guys, all these things that happen is we're going to see more flood of money come in the coming days, because a lot of other tickers, not saying they were sold to get this run, because that, you know, this is big. It was a massive, it's one of the biggest news breaks we've seen in. So you have to think about that stuff, right? That, you know, money's leaving your stocks. I had so many deals. Oh, wow, what's going on in the market? Everything's red. Guys, it's because it's red. It's because you're chasing. Well, not even chasing. It's a great chase. Never say chasing is bad, because when you do the math and you calculate what that company has brought in, it's very big. And that's another point I say to others is, you know, guys, when you can DD quickly, that skill is the biggest thing in the OTC by far. No technical will ever beat that fundamental of being able to look at a PR fast, read it, dissect it, and figure out the ROI. Wow, like the millions of dollars that's going to be in the nine figures, calculate that market cap, go look at that PPS. That's a buy all day today. Right. And that's why you saw it run thousands of percent. So that skill is underrated in the fundamental side. Being able to, you know, read a PR and do that DD is huge. So today was a perfect example of that. People asking me, is it chasing? No, it's not chasing. It's still undervalued, guys. So that's that one today. I hope everyone's had a good week. And like I said, yeah, I'll be it's been quite the week, needless to say. We're not going to touch on it, but so I had been a little bit off. So I need to, I went for an hour run today and sweat through a full t-shirt to try to clear my head. I truly believe, guys, you know, fitness, exercise is huge. And in this OTC, you know, no matter the, you know, ice in my vein, beast mode, you need to be clear headed to trade properly or you will make mistakes. And that's another thing I didn't touch on. In the OTC, guys, you know, life happens. And as we know, you know, everyone has struggles. Everyone is, you know, not too risk tall. When you're seeing, you know, six figure red, five figure red, like, you know, you're panicking, you're worried. That again, will go back to the fundamentals of DD and conviction. And a lot of people ask, and I know, you know, every spaces we've talked about it, you know, OTC method, how to, a point on DD, guys, and I hope you guys checked out that spaces on Sunday. And please check, I think he pinned his tweet on doing some DD on penny stocks. So it's key. It's so key in the OTC, guys, to know how to read a company and know their value and then have conviction, right? to be able to swallow those red days. Because things happen, and especially low floats, guys, like when somebody decides to sell market sell millions of shares or something, it's going to go down. That is not a bad thing, guys. If you have it, or if you have another stock that's green that day, that's why I teach with all my followers now, guys. It's like a robot system. It's you have to get a good core position at low dubs or wherever your entry is. Load up what you feel you need. I mean, it's different for everyone. But then when they do run, guys, unless there's a catalyst day or so, don't be afraid to shave the green, because that allows you to take advantage of, you know, one of your other plays that may be red due to profit taking or anything that the fundamentals didn't change. If nothing changes on your play, no fundamentals, nothing major, it's all the same. That's profit taking, or it's a market dump, or it's just a retrace, or, you know, it's filling a gap. That's where charts know where the gaps are. Talk to people if you don't, because they can be filled, and not all gaps get filled, but catalysts can break that. But if there's no catalyst for, you know, a week, and we're seeing it with MJWL now, there's a second acquisition coming that will put this valuation in the billions from my DD and conviction. That's why I did not sell. I just bought today. But it goes to show that, especially now with another runner, people pulled MJWL today. And when you get the 20 cents and stuff, guys, I've recommended it to my followers, guys. If you're a smaller trader, sure, MJWL, I believe, is going to a dollar or 50 cents very soon, but a dollar down the road. And it's massive, CGCX and what they're going to do. But at the end of the day, guys, you have to think about the ROI. So today we saw that because LCLP is a very similar, they just acquired a very similar company to CGCX with actually a higher valuation. On that side, we have, you know, IBH, which I believe, or something's coming in that Dr. Vin is co-founder of, but calculate that, guys, so you'll see that. So when on MJWL, I'm holding long. So I'm not pumping out there to say, hey, buy, buy, buy. I am buying on big dips because I know where it's going, but I have a lot of funds elsewhere that I can use. So it's never a bad thing to calculate that, especially when you get a big run up to 25 cents or so, and we're going to wait for a catalyst. So that applies for every single ticker. And I preached on it last week, was know when the next catalyst is. And if you don't know when the next catalyst is, obviously we don't know when the day the filing is going to drop, or, you know, when the news is going to come. But usually, you know, it's good to have companies that have Twitter and a social media presence, or like I do, I'm in contact with every CEO or IR person at that company. So I'm always, you know, not in the dark. If I'm ever in the dark, I don't love it. Right. Because it's uncertainty. And then you see, you know, stocks right now going, you know, tailing off a bit. And that's what we're seeing with one of my plays, NWGC. I'm still very bullish. I added again. And that is just because I have spoke with them and the new CEO. And I believe the shit with X person, Mark Miller, or whatever, that been lawyers and everything. So things have been put delayed. I do believe they're going current on time from what I know. And then MWWC, you're going to see that. So, but know that, you know, shaving profits is key, guys, especially, you know, when you're a smaller account, you need to, you know, take advantage of those, sell them when they start hitting pennies, roll them back into low dubs plays that you're going to get a ROI of at least a 4 to 5 bagger from low 2002, 0025, which I love to get in at those plays. So, that's what this market is, guys. And that's why, you know, I spoke with someone the other day where I, you know, I've been able to excel is a few different things. I'm a very good at reading people, companies, and the market. I'm knowing what my plays are doing tomorrow, this week, and knowing other days, guys. What happens on Mondays usually? We see a lot of runs, gaps and pops. Sell those gaps and pops, guys. Shave off the top of those, because they usually come right back down. Anytime you see a gap and pop and you own that play, shave a bit, unless you know something's coming really close. And Tuesdays, guys, we have that Blood Tuesday, right? Know that, and maybe shave a bit more on Monday. I think we see it a lot more on every day these days, right? And I'll go back to, you know, MMs are here and they're here to stay. So when, and what MMs mean is they're good. They want a stock to go up when it's ready. But if we're in between catalysts, or there's no buying pressure, there's low volume, they will work it down. I work with a couple of people sometimes each day, and I'll walk it up. I'll be on the L2, and the MMs will see me there with errors, and I'll slowly keep walking it up. and they won't sell to me because they know they don't want to lose their shares. They trade to each other, guys. They work things down, and that's what they do. And if there's no buying pressure, they're not just going to let it. They're going to make money during the day as it comes down. Then they get cheaper shares. When something happens, a catalyst or anything, they want it to run because they're going to make money as it goes up there, right? So they're not bad. You just have to know their mindset, the MMs, that is. So that's that on that front. Another person, that I was actually, I just kind of started following. Benzinga reached out to me to speak with them. So I kind of went back on what they did and their kind of interviews and stuff. And then I've seen another guy, can't remember his name, running that podcast. Zach Morris has been on it, Laid Back. And I listened to Zach Morris's interview. And they spoke about him, you know, not really caring about charts and not knowing fully to read them. He's learned to do that. And he's a lot further ahead than I am. But I don't touch big boards or anything like that. So that kind of was like, cool, man, this guy's, you know, come, did nothing, you know, had normal jobs, was a grinder, kind of like me. Really inspired by, Zach Morris, good for him. And the same shit that I'm dealing with. People go at him all day, Furu, Pump and Dumper, using this. And then you look at the 90% of people, guys, they're helping people make money. And that's what we're trying to do is, you know, we put in the time and not everyone does this full time. So you don't have the time to do it. So, you know, obviously this lately has been crappy because I'm a good person and it's hurtful. So I know that our goal is to help people, right? And we want to teach you to learn how to trade and do those things because, you know, every day we can't, you know, hold hands and go there. But learning to learn the market, guys, is very key. And it's been fun, guys. I love this. And I hope everyone, the OTC is not, this is here to stay. And you're seeing the amount of reverse mergers coming in. This is not going to stop. And it's very exciting because, you know, what was once frowned upon on Wall Street, IP, reverse mergers into penny stocks or were frowned upon. They are real now and they're going to happen a lot more. So one thing about that is speculation. So now we're speculating, you know, guys like me, and I'm digging in deeper than you could imagine. For example, SSOF, I had that one. And then they came out and said, no reverse merger, no connection whatsoever. No, that wasn't enough for me. So me and a good team, we dug deeper, conference calls with them. And as we can see now, it's happening. So just don't take anything by the surface. Don't react, guys. A big thing is don't react quickly. Don't go and jump and hit that market sell button the second you see a tweet. Because then you're going to hit yourself later when you're like, oh, geez, that thing ran back up. Just take the second to go do DD. Cross-check it. Type it into Twitter. Look at iHub. Do not react. The people that react quickly in the OTC, you know, you tend to regret it. That quick buy on the chase, right? Quick buy. You market buy, you hit this chase, and then all of a sudden it dumps out. But did you even go check to look at what was going on? What was the PR? What was the past price action? These are all very key things that making split decisions are not good. Especially like I just, you know, why when I went for a run today, I could tell I was not making the right decisions. I was going to tweet angry. You really got to check in with yourself in this game because the OTC is a jungle, guys. And there is walks of life out there that, you know, I have no idea how they go to sleep at night and put their heads down. Because not only are they affecting one person, they're affecting thousands of people with using their words, their influence, and their power. Basically, no base, no proof. So that's saddening. And that's the world we live in, guys. But it doesn't mean that, you know, people like me and others don't, you know, don't feel it. You know, you can have 100 DMs, which I've had. Don't worry, brush it off. Yeah, I will. I did. And I will, you know, adapt and conquer. But as a real person, if you don't feel that, then, you know, look in the mirror yourself, right? Because it's people's lives we're talking about here, right? And, you know, I see some here and everyone, we're selflessly giving our time for you guys. And, you know, yes, we benefit from it, guys. Yes, I front load a fucking play. But did I put the 4 hours in every night to find out if it was good? Do I buy that every dip on the way up? Do I bid support it for another probably 100% to make you guys money? Yes. So, you know, this shit that people talk about, the pump and dumping, the front loading, fucking cut it out. You know, it's like, can we just make a new Twitter and exit all those people and ban them? Like, I think that's what we need to do, maybe, like a FinTwit for real people. I don't know, guys, because I didn't do social media my whole life, and I guess that's why I'm adapting to this. So that's the world we live in, and some can take it more than others. And biggest thing I do, guys, just look at the account. If they start popping up with 5 followers and know this, you just ignore it, right? And I'm doing the same. But at the end of the day, guys, I love everyone in here. Thanks for showing up, and it's going to be a hell of a year, guys. Keep it going. Keep focused. One other big thing I noted from last time, which I cannot emphasize enough, which I still get people sending me 30 ticker portfolios with a bankroll of 20 to 100K. Guys, you got to cut it down. You got to slim the portfolio. It's quality over quantity. And that's key. Whether you're all like, I'm not a liquid guy. So I know a lot of people say cash is king. And I know some of my boys, they do a lot of cash on the side. I'm all in on my plays. I'm constantly shaving. I'm not out of my plays. I'm usually not going to have one that's not green that I can't shave and buy something. Does it affect me sometimes? Yes. But keep the plays tight, because you pick the good plays, right? You're gonna have quicker gains. You're going to be able to watch those plays closer. If you have 30 plays and you're not even a full-time trader, how the heck are you going to follow any of those catalysts? So, you know, cut it down to what you can manage. And I've been telling people, like, I went down, I had half a million. I was at 6 plays when I adapted in March, right? That's what you need to do, because I knew every single catalyst that was coming on that play. I knew the market sentiment. I knew exactly how Twitter felt about it. And I knew what the MMs were doing. I knew what the L2 was doing. I knew what the past 5 days trading action was. When someone asks me about one of my plays, I can tell you every single thing about it. If you cannot do that with any of your plays, start cutting down. And I know some people can hold a lot more than me, but I just don't like to hold a lot. But small accounts, guys, keep them small. Yeah, let's do a couple questions. If you guys got any yet, I can check mine. But let's throw a couple questions in, and then I'll dive into some other stuff.
I have a couple that people sent over, even though I told them to send it to Matt. So let me ask you. It says, how do you mentally face the deep red days, and what's your conviction on NWGC?
Yeah, so like I said, the conviction goes to your DD, right? And obviously, you know, it's not always 100%, right? And for me, risk tolerance comes into play, guys. That's a key factor, which I've talked about, is risk tolerance. I have a very high risk tolerance, right? So NWGC itself, that one I've added today again. But also, guys, in this play, is I'm good to add this because I'm already up realized on this a heavy amount. Because when I first entered it and called it at low dubs on the run up to 3 cents, guys, I knew that we were a ways away from filings and other stuff, right? Sometimes you have to, you know, Twitter hype can be good. But it's not pumping. Like, I still love the stock. And there's other people that were on it that pushed it up there. When that goes to 3 cents at that time where we were at, be able to take profits, right? For times like this, when something's going to retrace. Many plays, like, and that's one thing I've learned, is nothing goes straight up. So my conviction is still strong on it. Bob, we call him Silent Bob now. We need him to be a bit more vocal. But I believe what I've gotten back was, lawyers and stuff were tied up with Mark Miller and that stigma and the lawyer, the court cases, and the suit, which was dropped because it was false. So I'm still bullish on it. And at this price level, it's a great buy down here. It's red. It's one of my plays that I've retraced a lot. But like I said, I made money on the way up properly. But it's down at the bottom now, and I expect to hopefully see some filings soon. And there were some tweets out today with Bodie, who's a good one on it, and Burke. So keep an eye on it. I think it's good still. The red days for me are an opportunity, right? If you're betting with what you can lose, and you like your play, most people get scared when they don't know the play. You know, they bought the play because I called it or someone called it. That's fine. So you either have to trust me fully, even though I'm not a financial advisor, guys, not a professional, or You have to, you know, you have to sell if you're not ready to take that loss. I don't believe in stop losses, but that's, I have mental stop losses. But most of my plays, I'm so convicted on that red for me is just a buying opportunity. You know, people come at me saying, well, you keep buying and buying and buying. Yeah, sometimes the chart will go further down when I'm still buying, but I'm just buying because I know the end goal. I know where it's going to go. So that difference of, you know, maybe half a cent here and there, to me, I don't get fancy because I know where it's going in the end. So that's what I believe. So
did you also touch on like how like mentally you're able to take deep red days in your portfolio?
Oh, yeah. So like I said, so risk tolerance. So if you're willing, so if you're not putting the house on it or you're not putting money to have, that's the first step, guys. Do not play with what you cannot afford. None of us asked you to, you know, take out a loan or do, like, we just give you the plays. We hope that you on the other end are betting, so you're buying what's within your means. This is not a home run ball. This is not a lottery tickets. This is not your way out. Look at it like that. You know, then it's gambling. And, you know, people say, oh, you're a gambler. Yeah, I was a very high, big gambler. But that's what gives me, you know, a little bit more of that ice in my veins to take those red days. But like I said, guys, every day is a good day for me. You know, when I'm down 750,000 or whatever the hell it is, I just buying opportunities. And for others, if you're betting with what you have, that red day for you, if you're following my system or others, is did you have a green that day? Shave that green and then add that red, right? Because then it pops. You're going to have that little run maybe the next day. Because if nothing's changed in the fundamentals, then that red day is just an opportunity. And that's the way I look at it, right? If something does change, then yes, we have to sit back, we have to analyze it again and say, okay, I either have to scale out, or I have to do this, but nothing fundamentals, it's a buy, right? It's an opportunity is what you would call it. Oh, and also, go for a run, guys. I've really implemented that in the last few weeks. I used to not be able to leave my computer. I used to get FOMO because my phone's not the same. I want to be. But now, oh yeah, at least once a day, I'm going for an hour run, a quick bike ride, a quick lift. It clears the head, you bust a sweat. And it's one of the proven things that is one of the, you know, best cures for mental health as well. Yes. Get those endorphins out of you. So guys, exercise for sure.
Yes. And you could always be on the treadmill while you trade too, right? I don't know if you guys could do that, but sometimes I do that when I'm like stressed out and I'm on the treadmill and I just have like my phone right there and my laptop. I don't know if you guys are able to do that, but I think it helps.
Be very careful with that. Yeah, running really full speed on the treadmill, trying to check your Twitter. Oh yeah.
Not full speed, really, Matt.
A near miss. Yeah. So, well, yes, now I slow down to a walk. I'll do the walk and do it. But once I've tried to do it full speed.
Oh no, please. And, oh, you guys, man. Don't do full speed, please. That's crazy. Okay, Matt, here's another one. Ask him to touch on his CE plays a little more, please. And what's his favorites at the moment?
Ooh, it's a touchy question because a lot of these would be upset with you for asking that. I believe that they are going to be an absolute money printing machine for Canadians. One thing you have to do first is either if they've dropped filings, then that's good. That means they're going current, right? So two of mine that have dropped filings, all of them, plus the attorney letter, are IDVV and CCAJ, okay? They have dropped everything. And you guys have to understand, too, is they're not as quick to make them pink current or drop that CE as a stop sign play. So, like, we kind of have those, like, tentative 3 days, 4 days after, you know, all the ALs in that usually they're going to go current, right? CEs are different. There's a lot more to it, a lot more lawyers. Like, they've been delisted for a reason in the past. And there's no timelines is what I tell people, right? So I've played AAGC big before. I played Hiru. And there was just another one that did something the other day that ran. I didn't have it, though. But IDVV, CCAJ are the two that are the closest right now. I have DKGR with very, very heavy share count. They've been tweeting from their other Whistle something and then their Dextile Twitter account that they have a lithium deal with a fleet of trucks across America. And all these share structures are under $1 billion, some of them under $500 million. They're phenomenal. And when the CE does come down, you will see very, very big runs because they'll be undervalued. They'll be only at about a penny. And if you're talking, so a company, it's about the same thing, stop sign company going current, okay? So would you buy a stop sign company going current with under $1 billion float and in a certain sector? Most of these are going to pay a lot of money to get that CE removed. And most likely, you know, CCAJ, we think maybe a merger, IDVV, DKGR seems to have something going already. Those are three. SPBV was one. It was up 800% today, I have. Let me just pull it up. SPBV is one. I have... XXSPT is one I have. And that... still, I think, in trips, to be honest. And there was another one I tried to add today, but it's super thin. I won't say it, though. I don't have it yet. And what is one more I have? Oh, WCYN. It's super thin. I bought it the one day, and I market slapped a little bit, like just a little bit, and it went up 400% by accident. And I ended up filling. I thought it was 006, and I ended up filling at 02 cents. So it cost me a lot more than I thought. But they're all thin. They're going to be fun. So that's CEs. I love them. And when they do come down, they'll be a fun ride.
Someone here, someone that says they've been playing a lot of your plays, and they always going green, but they're having a hard time knowing when to scale out. They're every single one of the plays they get in, they're buying them when they're red. They're trying to get out when they're green. They're fighting, it seems like, a battle. Knowing when to scale out. Do you have a process of scaling out for them?
Yeah. So for like, obviously my plays right now are have eyes on them. And I won't say names, but they're slightly being attacked. MWWC, NWGC, you know, my first calls were on low pennies or low dubs, sorry. They both ran to 2 cents and 3 cents. So called two plays, MWWC at 001, 002, and NWGC 004, I think. They all had over 500% gains. So more than that, actually, 1,000 each or something more. You should have taken some profits, right? And I can't tell you, we can't tell you when to sell. So that's what we're kind of doing these spaces for, guys, is when you do have a play that I've called, you know, it's up to your risk tolerance. I'm convicted on these plays and I haven't sold much. Am I trading them while they're, yes, I'm shaving them and then I'm adding my reds. So that's shaving, that's adding, right? If you can find that system, unless something really crashes or, you know, my big guy is MJWL. So I've been red for, you know, a little bit because it's been a little retrace. But when that second acquisition is announced, which we'll believe, I believe in the billions, that's when we really ride. That's when we go. Because I've spoke with Dr. Vin. That guy's a genius. Co-founder of four companies totaling, you know, 10, 11 figures. So yeah, you gotta just the scaling out, knowing when the catalysts are. If you see a stock run 40%, shave some, please. It's even if they got a catalyst coming. It's just a play that, but keep your core. Know what you want to hold, right? Like my play is like LGBS right now. Solid. It looks amazing, right? I had a big core. Have I shaved a little bit here and there? Yeah, a little bit, right? Me shaving doesn't mean I've changed, right? No. And what's another one? Yeah, so D-Man, exactly, as well. Like, that's a solid stock. I don't push that as much to people because, you know, it's up there at, what, 4 cents or something like that. Like, it's a little bit pricier for some, right? Your ROI on that is a little different. Does the numbers line up once they do push those out there that it's worth 10 cents? Yes, 100% it is. That's why I hold a majority of it and I only shave a little bit. So yeah, you just got to calculate what is the market cap potential, the sector, what's the sentiment on Twitter. Guys, Twitter is huge. Like, you have to know if a stock's not talked about or is it getting like not talked about, maybe shave some. For me, when a stock's not talked about, I like adding because then no one's got eyes on it. But that's everyone's risk tolerance, right? So definitely just, guys, watch the runs. Watch, if you don't have L2, you know, ask somebody. See where the buying pressure's at. Shave the top. If you see a lot of people talking about it, it might have a couple-day run. So it's just feeling the market, being able to watch it all day. People, I tell some of my followers, the ones that can't, you know, look at Twitter or even in countries across the world, you know, that maybe don't see it all day or they can't follow the Twitter during the market, you have to choose your plays a little more carefully. You have to choose, you know, a secure, smaller play, low entry, that's safe. And then, guys, patience does pay. Don't hold down to nothing. But when you buy a play, I know all of us, oh, try not to look at your phone. Yeah. I dare you to try not. You're going to look at your phone all day going on with the PPS daily. But guys, the daily intra-trade, the PPS action does not matter if you know what it's worth. Unless something's changed. If you see a big dump on something, then yes, 100% check Twitter, check iHub, check the details. Did something change? No. Then either buy or sit on your friggin' hands, because that's the OTC, guys. And that's what, you know, that's when you have to start stomaching it, because this is not meant for everybody, this OTC. And this is why a lot of big boards, I have very big boards, guys, with large accounts coming to me now that, you know, I help them out. They just don't know. You're seeing a lot more, you know, big board traders come down, because, you know, you see the gains that are possible here, guys. There's no other market you can really pull in hundreds of percent, 2,000% today. Like, that's real, and it's not going anywhere. But you have to be able to stomach the drops. And that's both sides of the ball, guys.
This one here, they want to know your daily routine. And then they went to say, with your gains, you don't have to release your daily routine because you must be doing some secret sauce.
Yeah, no secret recipe, guys. Like I'm trying, this is kind of why I want to do the spaces. It's every person in the market, you know, has a different approach. There is many ways to make money in the OTC. You have to find your way. If you like safe, if you want to, you know, read the charts, find very bottoms, you know, day trade, you know, put X amount of dollars in every trade, keep it level, keep it, you know, conservative. That's one way, right? Play the charts, play this. If you want to, you know, on my side is I wake up on the West Coast, 5 a.m. I take my dog out. I do my routine. I have my shakes. Go through Twitter. Catch up on all my DMs for you night owls that stay up till 3 in the friggin' morning or elsewhere. I'm in bed by 9:30, 10 p.m. every night. Unless there's something crazy on the market, then I can't sleep. Then I stay up all night looking at my Twitter and researching. And then I go through all the Twitter. Find out, you know, did anything drop? Was there tier changes? Was there a CE removal? Go through every, and that's why you need to have a plays that you can handle. I go through every one of my plays. I look at everything that's going on. I see the open, what, you know, if there's a gap, X amount, all that stuff, analyze everything. And prior to that, like, I have notes. I know what my plays might do that day. Shit, if there's news expected and it doesn't come, we might see a sell-off, right? Be ready to buy that if you think the news is still coming. So in the morning, that's my routine. Check out iHub. I don't do it as much now because I'm so busy on Twitter with DMs. But I do all that. I go through it all, right? That's the routine. You have to prepare. You know, one morning I slept in for the first time ever in 9 months. I was so flustered. Like, my whole day was done. And that's because I didn't prepare. I didn't see what the opening was. I didn't see what the sentiment of Twitter was. I didn't know what was going on. So be ready, guys. Prepare. It takes all the stress out, right? I put my headphones, I jam out to music all day. I barely eat all day too. I do liquid shakes and all that stuff because I can't, like, my adrenaline's going that I eat. But now I exercise. Take a break, guys. Step away. I used to, like, be so engaged that I could not look away from my phone or the computer. But now also my conviction is very high that I don't need to really watch it all day. That was my, like, you know, my OCD dopamine, like, I need to watch. Now I kind of walk away. I'll take the dog. I'll go grab a coffee. I'll sit by the water. I have my phone, yes, and I'm checking in. But just relax. Like I said, guys, life is stressful to begin with. This FinTwit, Twitter, OTC, you're living, if you do it as a side gig, just stay in that lane. If it's your side gig and you're just trying to make some extra cash, don't grab 30 friggin' tickers and with 10 grand and put 500 in each and think you're going to make millions and save your family. Guys, that's not what it's here for. You know, I have a lot of people that come to me with, you know, $500, 10,000, 500,000. But they just want to know, you know, pick people's brains. And that's the biggest thing, guys, is if you really want to learn this, do not think that you're above anybody. Like, continually learn. I learned so much from traders all day. It's not even funny. I was the one that reached out to all the traders and said, hey guys, like, I don't know if you're going to message me back, right? Like, that's the message I get now is, hey, I don't think you'll ever read this, but no guys, I will read it. I get back to everybody. Because I want you guys to learn and help. Yes, does all this teaching help my plays and all your plays? Do I truly want everyone to succeed and make money, you know, pay for your kids' surgeries, their colleges, get out of debt, financial freedom? Yes, guys, it is the greatest feeling. You know, with my mental health, my depression at times, my injuries, you know, this now is so satisfying. Not the money, giving back. Like, that is why I've been crushed so much lately. And I've had to do some real, like, Zen moments, right? Because, you know, when you're a really good person and your name is being dragged through the mud, you can only ignore so much, right? And I know I have the support of 16,000 people that follow me that say it. So guys, just be kind, be nice, and have some fun, guys. Have some fun on Twitter. You know, pick your plays, don't chase. I've had to learn to adapt a bit more when I have a bigger following to not, you know, stuff and complain why I make my moves, because that's big as well, because I understand that people do follow blindly. And guys, that's not always recommended. Please do not follow blindly. You can trust me. Believe me, you can trust me, because every one of my plays that I'm in, unless something changes, I'm buying the dips. I'm bidding the support. I'm maybe making mistakes that I shouldn't have, selling one stock to go slap another stock when, you know, I already have X amount of millions, but I want that stock to succeed. I do not want, you know, irrelevant, baseless crap to happen and it drop. I will sacrifice my money to help you guys so you don't lose your money or your opportunity to be a part of a play that could really change your life.
That's extremely powerful. That whole last bit right there, that's next level. And I think that's something that just a lot of people can't wrap their head around, that someone on the internet is really out here with that big of a heart, with that pure of intentions. And I think that's why, I mean, I talk to you every day. Every morning I text you, I love you, go get after it. It's your world. But, you know, it's just something that everyone in here, I don't know how many people are in here, but we are all blessed to be able to be a part of this and be a part of something that we're all trying to push and grow and have someone like you leading the charge. I think that's, you know, you've shown proven success. You've shown, you know, hey, I was here, I took my account here, now I'm here, but I'm learning. And I think that's the biggest thing. You've accepted that you're always going to be learning and there's no ego. And I think that's really beautiful, brother.
Thank you, Matt. Yeah, no, it's true, guys. Like, we're all in this together, right? We're all starting from, you know, small accounts. We're all trying to build something, right? To get that financial freedom in a world that, you know, is tough right now. Whether it's money, whether it's mental health, whether you're losing loved ones. I feel like I've had so many close friends, like people, you know, cancer, this, like, there is real stuff out there, guys. And that's what bothers me, that this Twitter world, you know, is so toxic sometimes. And that's where, you know, I was jaded to a lot of people in the world before. And this is just proving my point. But like we said, guys, let's unite. You know, let's block out the noise and, you know, go for the better good. You know, at the end of the day, we're trying to, you know, build a future for your family, yourself. And that's why, you know, I don't speak about just stocks all the time. I speak about my life. And that's not to, you know, say anyone first. No, I encounter everyone with an equal platform. Normally, I bring myself much further down. So, they feel comfortable that, you know, you're not alone. There's a light at the end of the tunnel. And those are the messages that tear me up at night when people message me and say, you know, I'm going through that. And thank you for sharing that. That's real. Okay, guys. And this is real. All of this. I don't believe this is just about stocks. Like I've said before, most of my money will go back. My foundation, I'm already, you know, in the works with advisors.
Okay. So Daily Stock Guy asks, what does Matt recommend someone up 150% on CADX, but still expecting filings for a bigger run?
Yeah, so this goes to custos, guys. Custos are tricky. CADX is great. There's many custos that are very solid. I recommend keeping low share structure custos to start with. But right now with CADX, it's got volume, it's got hype, it's got some runs. You know when the catalyst might come, right? They're a filing, a merger, but it's a custo, right? And as we see with certain custos, they can be dropped at certain times or something cannot pan out. So it's good to secure. And I say this with my custos sometimes, I'm usually, if I've entered them, OTC method had said, well, you know, when a reinstatement happens or something and then it runs that 100% that day, you wait for it to come down. You know, I don't read charts, but I have to do, and I do know them. Let it come back down to where it was, right? He was nailing it. That Kiko Stocks is very intelligent when it comes to, you know, market charts, entries. You need that stock to come back down to where it belongs, right? Do not chase that up just because it was reinstated. If you did not have that stock before it was reinstated, not a good idea to buy it that day when it runs up. Wait for it to come back down, settle, because the court case is probably a little bit away. And then once it is reinstated, make sure that the company has a Twitter or the like whatever the custodianship is, they're informing you of what's going on and the dates. But always shave, right? Because you're going to have some red days. Like if something doesn't happen with CADX in the next little bit, you might see some red. And then because you shaved that green day when it popped 50% yesterday, I think that was, then you can rebuy on the low end. And that's where I really say is, guys, get your core early. I average up all the time. Do not believe that because you got an entry at 001 or 2 that you shouldn't add higher, because that's where you can really build your core. Is say you pick, you entry the play at 002, custo, not custo, whatever, good share structure, possibility to be pennies, which most of them end up being. Watch that. If it hasn't ran a bit, keep adding if you can afford it or whatever your entry is. Add your shares, get to a share count where say 1,500,000, whatever it is, or for some of us 10, 20, get that. And then when it does do those runs, you're more willing to say, you're not fearing missing out, right? You're going to shave some. And then when it does retrace before that next catalyst, you could add, or you can just say, you know what? I made some profit. You took $5,000 profit, or then you add that to one of your red plays. And if you keep doing that, that's how I've been very successful in the last few months with red. That I go big on certain plays, but I'm always shuffling. I'm always shaving, buying. If something has a catalyst coming, if something has a catalyst hit, I'm going to shave that, right, heavily, because when's the next catalyst, right? Will that retrace a bit? Will there be profit taking? 100%. So don't just ride the catalyst up and I've been guilty of this. I'm sitting there, I'm running around, I'm happy. Things just pop 70%. I'm up this amount of money. And then I forget, shit, I come back later and it's down to 30%. It's because people took profits. So you have to just be in the zone, and that goes back to being focused, being mentally prepared, knowing your moves before they happen, if something goes red or green, because it's very hard. And even the best of us, you know, impulse is very, very bad in the OTC. You don't want to have impulse moves. You want to have somewhat of a plan or at least an idea of what you're going to do when something happens. And I can't preach that enough, guys. Do not bitch, cry, DM me, oh my gosh, it's down, it's not, or it's this, or I didn't do this. I get it. I will help you. I will coddle you, so to say. But I can only do it so long, because you guys have to prepare for these things that happen, right? It's the OTC at the end of the day, guys, and it's a jungle. So prepare. Make sure you do your DD.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to know what's your opinion on, because I know a big thing for you is network, is your net worth. How would you go about building a core team? Because I know a lot of people on OTC, they either fend on their own, which, you know, is, it makes it very long with just your own development. And I know a lot can progress by having a stronger team around them to help, you know, with DD and all this other different essentials to being successful. Like, what building a team, and what would you recommend for people who start off?
Yeah, exactly. Great question. So 100%, guys. So one thing is, which, you know, where I've got respect in the OTC by big name, small, is just start off, be kind, you know, do not go and bash a stock or comment on a stock when, you know, you have really no idea or you didn't do the DD, right? People will see that in you. So if you're a good person on Twitter, you're all this, you will be more respected, right? You will grow your brand essentially. With teams, I one thing I don't do is, which I don't know why people, there's no pump and dumps. There's no teams that, you know, buy a play, we run it up and then we all sell our shares. It just boggles me that people think this is real, and I'm sure it does happen. I don't know who they are, but I associate with, and I only follow 94.3 people. Follow who I follow as well. I'm sure there's others that I don't follow, but start doing that, and then start on your level, right? Like, I have people, oh, what's your team or your Discord? I probably won't ever start a Discord. I won't ever have a Telegram room. It's just me. I just don't want to do it. My things go to Twitter. Like I said, I am humbled by the people around me. Friendships in the OTC, in the Twitter world. I have a select team that, you know, we work together. Some do charts. Some dive into CEOs. They're very good. VP of a company. They call the CEOs. They're very good at putting together emails that are well worded. So those kind of things. So don't reach for, I guess I could say, and always dream big, but start in your lane, so to say, right? Like, no one's better than anyone, but just start building, start reaching out to people, you know, maybe on your level, other traders that you've kind of connected with, ones that maybe retweet your stuff, engage in your stuff, you know, don't feel like embarrassed to just DM them and say, hey, I'm X and YZ, I'm Matt, or how's this? I really liked your post there. You did good. Guys, you know what the biggest thing where you get respect in this Twitter world and everything? Start clapping for others. Like, start clapping for others. Because if you cannot be selfless enough to really be happy for other people, then that you're already losing. If you're envious or jealous when someone else succeeds, that's not someone I would ever associate with. So work on those life skills, and believe me, success will be attracted to you. You will attract success. You will attract good people. And that's how you really start to build trust and teams. You are someone that people want to be around, right? It doesn't matter your small accounts. I recommend the small accounts, guys. Follow us, other traders that are, you know, succeeding. And most of you are doing it. Ask me questions, like my Twitter spaces now or my DM. Let me try to let you know how I do it, and then you know, amplify those, start using those, but definitely got to put the time in. There's no free passes in this world, we all know that.
I guess Burgix Mining Consultants says that they just made a tweet saying they did any work nor has plans to conduct any work for New World. We have not been engaged by NWGC to conduct any work in South Dakota or elsewhere. We are currently investigating the source of this information with relevant authorities. But then it looks like NWGC's Twitter. Okay. Yeah, you're
so
good.
So Mindic, hold up. So yeah, I know exactly what he's talking about. So yeah, I'm just reading the tweet now as well. So when I go back to impulse decisions, right? That was what the sell off was today. Did I immediately go talk to New World Gold and my contacts? 100%. So simple enough. Like you just said, New World Gold said, please correct your tweet. I'm sure this was an honest mistake. Thank you. We also have sent this via email. So that's New World Gold going to Burgix Mining Consultants. So was there maybe an IR person that messed up and was back in this, or maybe something else has changed? Dig into it before you make impulse decisions, because I did that right away. And did I eat the hell out of that dip today? Yeah, I did. Do I tell anyone to do the same? No, but do not read something right on the surface all the time, because there's always something behind it. And I will tell you guys, one thing you can trust with me is there's if I believe in a play and I've done the DD, period. So, and I'm not saying every play is going to go to 5, 10, 20 cents, but I still believe and I know that New World Gold has something. And this risk for reward on this play, if they in fact hit lithium, which they are very close to Elon Musk's lithium mining, then we're talking a very large payday. And for me, especially at these levels, it's a buy. So yeah, New World Gold has already contacted and tweeted it. So people complaining about, oh, they haven't tweeted anything yet, there's no news. Sometimes, guys, a quiet period happens, right? And that's why maybe shave a bit, check the charts, see how far it might go down, see where it might retrace to. Yeah, so that's where it's at right now. New World Gold's already contacted it, so keep an eye on that guy tomorrow.
He just DM'd me again on it. So essentially, you would say that since they, you know, preemptively got on top of it, responded, and handled it, you would say that's a good for the stock overall.
100%. That's if we didn't hear anything and they just let it sit by the wayside, for sure, right? That's what people ask me. Oh, why are they going after Mark or GS about MWWC? Guys, these companies are real companies. They do not need to reply to random baseless accusations, right? That just makes them on their level. Like, they're stooping to those people's levels. They will provide to. They do not care. Well, they do about the daily PPS that someone's going to bash their stock and then they'll sell because guys like me or others are just buying it up. They will deliver when they need to, and they will just, you know, answer random shit. New World Gold, professional, what, we haven't heard from them in a week? Yeah, clearly they're watching, guys. So the mining company, they're probably in talks, and I'm sure we're going to find out about this very soon. So this doesn't change anything for me. It gave me a buying opportunity today, in my opinion, but my plays are not the one-all-be-all plays, guys. There's lots out there. So
go ahead, Matt. I was just going to say, as a lot of you know, I'm newer to the OTC, but one of my biggest winnings ever was a ticker UAVS, and it was a drone company, and I was buying it, you know, sub 20 cents, and it ended up running to like $7, $8, and $10 plus. And, you know, they were getting a lot of saying, oh, it's nothing to do with Amazon, nothing to do with, they don't even have drones. And they just kept quiet. And a lot of people kept getting worried, but I just kept buying the dips, and I had strong conviction, and that was my biggest payday. And I know I'm talking, you know, apples to oranges here, but NWG's kind of showing me that same kind of sentiment that UAVS was showing me. They show up when they need to, but they're letting other things talk. So I am really excited to see how that turns out. This is a question for you, Matt. I guess it would be different. I guess you could answer a percent or however you want to answer it. But they said, for you, what's a dollar amount that is a happy gain for you? Which obviously I'd be different for everyone. Everyone has a different, you know, bankroll here. But they're wondering, when do you feel happy to, like, start looking at a dollar amount? When do you feel happy? Which I think is a kind of a goofy question because you really should be looking at percentages. But I am interested to see your spin on that.
There's no dollar amount. Like, I love to answer that in a sense. But for me, I'm happy when stocks are successful, stocks perform. A dollar amount for me, you know, I sleep the same when I'm up a million or I'm down a million in a day. And that's not because I'm made of money, because I came from nothing. But at the end of the day, that intraday gain or loss, when people want to say, oh, this, it really doesn't matter to me, because, and you know, that can be taken different ways, but I respect it. I'm happy for it. I don't want to be red. But at the end of the day, my goal is the end of the goal, the end of the year, the eight figures, you know, the nine figures 5 years from now, who knows? But the daily piece or the daily intra-trade ups and downs, you know, don't affect me. Because each day what affects me is if something happens to my stock, if something happens to my play that's good or bad, it's a great day. If I get great news on a play or a new advancement, that's when I'm happy. When it's up, I expect them to be up, right? I expect to be up money every day. If I'm not up money, then it's just an opportunity. So yeah, good question, but and that's different for everyone, right? You know, don't reach too far. Don't step out of your lane, I guess you could say. Is just go with your gains. Start small, man. I remember when I first started, when I had a five-figure day, I was running around the house. When I had my first six-figure day, or I hit six figures for the first time, or a six-figure day, oh, I was running around the house. I'm celebrating. That, you know, used to that a bit, right? But be happy, guys. Enjoy it. Be excited. You know, you're not, that's what we're here for, is at the end of the day, whatever you do with your money, that's on you. But yeah, be excited. But just stay humbled along the way.
Matt, so, there's another question. SAPX dumped hard today and people lost. What is your opinion?
Not my opinion. I don't know if you want my true opinion, but, yeah, so it seems like someone's after me, on everything I touch. So, news came out, PR came out, filings coming. I can't change what you know, someone tweets that has a massive influence, right? What I will, you know, sit on the back burner is when MWWC and all these ones go current and they become real companies. Does anything happen to this man? Does any repercussions happen? Or does every sheep keep following this person, you know, aimlessly trusting this person? That's what you're gonna have to look at yourself, and that he's gonna have to look at himself. But didn't change for me. I still believe in the play. It's a sad thing, right? You could affect my money, but now you're affecting many, many people when I call a play. So that's all I'll speak on that about.
Yeah. And where do you do your, or where do you get your DD on these OTC stocks?
First and foremost, go to OTC markets. It's the holy grail right off the bat. You go there, check out share structure. You check out company profile. You check out website. You check out their Twitter. You check out disclosures. Where are they at? Current. Is the transfer agent verified? Do they have a verified profile? That's your go-to first, where you get all the news, finances, everything. And then I will cross-check with Twitter. I'll check all the DD on Twitter. Because most likely, guys, people say, I'll find my own plays. Don't worry yourselves as a small account trying to find your own plays, because there's many of us that are one, like some of us, some of them calling them at a volume. So they're going to call them at a trips and great traders with volume. When something happens and volume comes in, come on, guys. So I'll read off that. Then I'll do the DD on that play off their tweet. And then I will load or do whatever and load usually. Check iHub. Check some bears, what they say. I don't have stock twits, but check stock twits. Use all that stuff. And then if you get your entry, you're happy in the share structure, the setup, the Twitter sentiment, all that stuff, and get your core, and then go deeper. Email the CEO. Call the company. Go to those lengths, right? Look up all the CEO, CFO. Look up all their LinkedIn. Make sure you know management is what you want to bet on, guys. You want to bet on the management. You want to bet on the sector. What do they have in that sector that's disruptive? You have to make sure that they have something that differs themselves from the rest. They may not, but then just then where do you play it as? If it's at 005, a market cap of 4 million, is it worth 20 million? Okay, so then, you know, that's three times your money, four times your money, five times your money. So figure out those things, and then that'll, you know, let you figure out how convicted you are on the play. But OTC markets, iHub, their Twitter, their social media, email the company, the LinkedIn, all of these are factors or things you have to go through right away.
Nice. Thank you, Matt. And then last one, what will get our SHN to move? What's the timeline, do you think?
Yeah, this one, I spoke with Ashley, like, he's a great guy, great CEO, really for the shareholders. There's just a lot to unpack here, right? There's, you know, I haven't seen personally a play in the OTC that has this much to kind of unpack with spinoffs, dividends, legacy, free shares, discounted shares, where uncertainty comes panic or sells. And that's kind of what we're seeing at times, right? So they're, you know, they'll still be able to show to the OTC what they're going to deliver, where the value is. And, you know, are you going to buy the new shares? Are you going to get the discounted shares? Those kind of things. So, just a lot to unpack on this one. I like the CEO, I like the company, but yeah, that's kind of where I'm at with that one.
How do you feel? Do you want to wrap it up and then, see everyone today and Wednesday?
Yeah, let's do I love the questions. I love it all, guys. And like I said, I could always go longer. I appreciate it. We did an hour. Let's keep it to that. And we'll continue. Guys, bring your questions next week. I'll have a few other things that I wanted to touch on that I didn't yet. But I just want to say, everyone, guys, appreciate the support, guys. And just keep being happy. Keep, you know, being positive, right? There's a lot of shit out there. So that's all I ask people is just be kind. I really don't have any patience for it anymore. I'll just block people, which I'm on a roll right now. I think 100 in the last week. It's been fun. But yeah, just treat others the way you want to be treated, guys. Don't, you know, call out pump and dumps, guys. Like, people see when I post my daily pickups. That's why I do it. Do I have to do all this? No. Do I want to? Yes. That, but you know, just block the noise. And I do want to thank all my followers, guys. I don't even have to engage with anyone anymore. You guys come in like an army just going after these people. So truly, truly amazing, guys. And I appreciate that support. And let's keep going.
Awesome, guys. It was great having you guys. We will see you on Sunday. And we have Jenny Ta as our guest. So we will see you guys Sunday. Bye, guys. It's a whole lot of money in the smoke. Broke that broke.